Ivan, how are you?
Oh, good morning.
I'm Chris, nice to meet you. Grab a seat in the chair just there. All right, Ivan, listen, thanks for coming in. I appreciate you taking the time and also for filling in your preclinical survey out there, which I've had a look at. So in Ivan's experience, obviously he was having trouble sleeping, there were some snoring issues. He'd gone to his GP and the GP had referred Ivan to a sleep physician for an in-lab sleep test, which he undertook. The sleep scientist will be recording the patient's body position, their airflow, the respiratory effort, their oxygen levels. They'll also be looking at brain activity and heart activity to determine stages of sleep as well. And the last part of that puzzle is actually a visual recording to record the patient's sleep visually to ascertain exactly what's happening and when. So Ivan, here's the device. We have this 3D printed titanium airway here that at night allows the air, if you're not getting enough air through your nose, if the congestion or resistance is building up, we can add to that airflow by breathing through the device as well. So the air enters here, it'll travel through the appliance in an enclosed airway, and it just exits back there behind the last tooth straight into the back of the throat. So if the nose is congesting, we can continue to get air through what we call the second nose.
The Oventus technology is a unique device that is backed by robust science. Compared to other appliances, Oventus would be useful in a patient who has nasal obstruction or is a mouth breather.
So once we have the patient's records, the digital record of the patient's mouth is uploaded onto the proprietary software, and from there we customise a design for the patient based on their anatomy and maximising airflow to the back of the throat. Once the design file has been finalised, it'll be converted to a file that will be transferred to the 3D printer, and then the 3D printer will print that file along with around 50 to 60 other files at the same time. If we combine the proprietary software that we developed with the CSIRO with the ability to print in three dimensions, that's a massive advantage. It's been incredibly helpful to be able to locate our premises within the CSIRO at Clayton and next to Lab 22. I mean, they are obviously world leaders in 3D printing and handling titanium, and we've worked with them on the development of the technology. So to have their support on a commercial venture, producing devices that are going to patients is a massive benefit for us. So once the devices are finished being printed and polished in Melbourne at the CSIRO, we'll obviously make sure that they comply with their quality standards. We then manufacture the polymer parts of the device that engage the teeth. They're then packaged with some cleaning tablets, a sonic cleaner, patient instructions and a key to adjust the device, and then shipped to the clinician for delivery to the patient. So approximately 3 or 4 weeks since we saw Ivan last time, Ivan's now returning to pick up his device, see how he goes. So Ivan, I've got your device here. What I'll do now is I'll just try this in and make sure it fits,
sure.
And then we'll show you how to use it. Excellent. Well, good luck. We hope you get a great result. And obviously, if you need anything else, don't hesitate to give us a call or pop in and see us. That's your device.
Thank you.